Hi. I needed a circuit that can detect whether the AC power is on or not for one of my projects. A quick Google search returns nothing useful sadly, but if we change the search keywords, we find a product that looks like it might just do the job. Although the looks of it didn't match the price tag it carries. It doesn't have many parts, only if somehow I could reverse engineer it. But a good fellow does exactly that in his webpage. It also has two more ways to detect AC power for a microcontroller, but I was interested in this one only as it uses much less parts, is safe and can be easily built. So without any further ado, let's understand the circuit and build it. This video is sponsored by PCBWay. If you want professional looking PCBs for your projects, visit their website and without a second thought, order the PCBs. You can choose the solder mask, PCB thickness, number of layers and so much more. It is very easy to order PCBs too. Just click on quote now and enter the details, or you can use the quick order option on their website. Once ordered, you will receive them in no time. So go ahead and order your PCBs today. Alright, let's understand the circuit first. The 150K resistor is in series with one of the AC terminals. Its function is to drop most of the AC voltage across it, so that at the output only a couple of volts are delivered, bringing the AC voltage close to what we use in DC circuits. This is what the first stage of a circuit looks like. To calculate the current, let's assume the load is a short circuit. After using Ohm's law, we see that the current flowing is around 1.5 milliamps. Now we can use Ohm's law again to calculate the voltage across the resistor, which equals to around 225 volts in my case, where the input voltage is 230 volts. Now we can easily calculate the open circuit load voltage, which will come to 5 volts now after using KVL. The power rating of the resistor can also be easily calculated. This concludes the first stage of the circuit, but of course it's not accurate. There's a lot of things that come into play while doing AC calculations like power factor, but it's good for a start. After that, the 5V AC is converted to 5V DC using a rectifier. At the output of the rectifier, there is a 5.1V Zener diode to limit the voltage if something ever goes wrong at the input side. Now we can use this DC voltage as an input to a microcontroller, but it is not completely safe yet. The AC and DC side are not isolated, meaning if something goes wrong, there is a good chance it can directly affect our DC input to the microcontroller and blow up the microcontroller. Also, what if you are using a 3.3 volts microcontroller? We cannot use this in that circumstance. To solve all these problems, we use an optocoupler at the DC output, which works at the same voltage level as your microcontroller. Also, it isolates the AC from DC side, making it completely safe. The capacitor is for decoupling and an LED in series is to visually see if the AC input is there. After creating the circuit diagram, I converted it to PCB and arranged the components in a way similar to the product I saw online. As I did not already have all the parts, I ordered them online and parallelly I ordered the PCBs through PCBWay to save time. After 7 days, I received the PCBs. As you can see, it is packaged very safely and the quality of the PCBs is as expected. I gathered the components and noticed that I used the wrong footprint for the screw terminal, and also I couldn't find the MB6M rectifier, so I had to buy a different one. But it's nothing we cannot solve with love. A bit of love is all we need. As you just saw, I soldered the screw terminals with a lot of love and it's doing its job perfectly. At the output of the Zener diode, we measure around 5.2 volts. The resistor is successfully dropping most of the input voltage, and at the output of the rectifier, we measure only 5 volts, which is aligned with our expectations. After completing the circuit, we can see that at the output, we measure nothing, because we must apply input for it first. After soldering the headers and applying 5V to it, we can measure 5V at the output header when AC power is off. This is because we have pulled the collector of the transistor inside the optocoupler high with a 10K resistor. So normally it will output whatever input you provide to it. Once the transistor turns on, the current will choose the least resistance path and we will measure 0V at the output terminal. And we are done with the AC detection video. I hope you liked it. If you did, please leave a like and subscribe. It helps the channel a lot. Till next time.